Dear students, so I am here once more and I'll keep meeting with you again and again, and my endeavor will be to clarify everything before you. Though I have given a video of the chapter Lost Spring, still there are some things which need to be explained in a better way, and here in this part I've taken the literary device, the poetic device used by Anish Jung in the chapter. You know, dear students, why does the poet use the literary device? In order to create a picture, in order to make the things more graphic, so that you just create that picture in your mind and understand that clearly. So, I'm making those poetic devices clearer, as I could not take them in my previous part. So see the title of the page, Understanding the Text, Poetic Device in your chapter, Lost Spring. Now see some devices which are used here. Simile. The first poetic device which I am taking is simile, and the author has used this device in two sentences. One is like morning birds, when she talks about the sahib who meets the author, and she inquires whether why doesn't he wear the footwear, then he embarrassingly replies and then runs like the morning birds and join the army of barefoot children. So in the sentence like morning birds, it is the poetic device. Similarly, why? Because the author is comparing birds here with children. So next device which is used by the author is like tongs of a machine. When she talks about a bangle maker, Savita, who is a young girl, and her hands move mechanically, very swiftly, just like the tongs. You know, tongs is an instrument to grasp the objects, and that moves very fast. Similarly, that girl is so skilled in joining the bangle, pieces of bangles, that her hands are being compared to the tongs. Now next sentence, an army of barefoot boy, which I talked in your first device, like morning birds, Sahib joined embarrassingly. He joins an army of barefoot boys. And now see, the word army consists of the device metaphor. And here army means group of children. The next sentence, few airplanes fly of Firozabad. This is a metaphor. And actually, dear students, one sentence may contain one, two or more devices, and the same is the case here. This sentence contains metaphor also, alliteration also. Metaphor, you know, few aeroplanes fly over Firozabad. A metaphorical expression is given, and this sentence actually means ki Firozabad is not developed. That is why airstrip is not maintained above the village. Another device, alliteration, and this is very familiar device to you, where consonant sound is repeated in the same line. You can see here sound F is being repeated in words few, fly and Firozabad. Then next is drowned in the air of desolation. Here also author creates a metaphorical picture. Drowned, the word drowned, that means when some object gets inside into the water. And here the author is talking about the temple in the chapter, which is now in shambles, and the word drowned convey this meaning. The next device is Sahib-e-Alam. Sahib-e-Alam, you know students, Sahib means Lord and Alam means universe. According to the meaning of the name, he should be the universe. He should be the Lord of the universe. But ironically, he is so poor. He is an abject. He is lurking in abject poverty. See, his name is opposite to what the meaning is. It can be contrast also, because two contrary situations are created here. The next sentence, when author sees the boy Sahib-e-Alam later, and he is carrying a tin canister instead of carrying a plastic bag in order to fill it with the articles he finds in the garbage. So that tin canister seems to be heavier than the plastic bag. This means the two objects are being compared here, plastic bag and tin canister. One more device is used here, and that is metaphor. You know, symbolic meaning, metaphorical meaning. Like he is not happy when author watches him. He is not happy as he used to be happy while picking up the garbage. So that meaning, that literary device is also here. Then next sentence, she has bangles on her hands but not the light in her eyes. This is a paradox. Why? Two situations are put opposite to each other. That means something which is opposite to each other. Paradox. Like she is young, that is why she is supposed to be able to see, but because she has become blind, that is why this sentence contains paradox. It can also contain contrast. It has the same meaning. Then, next sentence, Simhapuri, a place so near to Delhi yet miles away from it metaphorically. Now again, two situations are created here. Simhapuri, miles away, metaphorically. Metaphor is also here. Miles away means in terms of development, advancement. Delhi is the capital of India. So advanced, so infrastructurally advanced. But Simhapuri in the vicinity of Delhi is so underdeveloped. So, dear students, here again three devices, antithesis, contrast and metaphor, which I have forgotten to write. Then next sentence, for adults, rag picking is a means of survival. For children, it's wrapped in wonder. It again consists of two devices, antithesis, contrast, because two situations, opposite situations are created here. For adults, it's a means of survival. But for children, it's wrapped in wonder. That means it's a source of entertainment. This is the metaphor also. Just like the earlier sentence, wrapped in wonder. This phrase consists of the device metaphor. Then, scrounging for gold. And next sentence, rag picking has acquired the proportions of fine arts. These both sentences create two devices. One is hyperbole, another is metaphor. Hyperbole, dear children, hyperbole is an expression where things are exaggerated. That means they are talked about more glowingly than what they are in reality. A magnifying picture of the thing is created. Magnifying. Like rag pickers scrounging for gold. Now you see in the word scrounging and in the word gold, the device is clear. Gold is something which is so valuable for everyone. And you see, children, coin of 1 rupee or 2 rupee is compared to gold, which they find from the garbage. And they search in the garbage so minutely that it has acquired the proportions of fine arts. Hyperbole again. Then, this I just made an explanation of the device. Antithesis is a device where two things are juxtaposed, because this is the new device for you people. Okay, students, this is enough in this video. We'll meet again.